Hey guys, this is your Cranium Xenar here. I just want to know, like, I don't know, this is a good free-for-all I had in Afghan. It was Quickscoping. There's a few things I want to talk about today, but yeah, this is my first commentary, so I don't know. Tell me what you think about it in the comments. Likes, rate, comment, subscribe, you know. Alright, first thing is Battlefield 3 or Modern Warfare 3. I just want to know what you guys think about Battlefield 3. Like, are you going to get it? Do you think it'll be good? Will you play it more than Modern Warfare 3? Or, like, I don't know. Do you even think there is going to be a Modern Warfare 3? Like, my personal thing is, I do think there's going to be a Modern Warfare 3, and I think they're going to release, like, beta information about it this week. Or, I mean, not this week, this month. I hope that Modern Warfare 3 is really good because I really enjoy playing this game. But from the looks of it now, I will be getting Battlefield 3 because it looks really sick. But if Modern Warfare 3 comes out, I think if they keep quickscoping, they fix like the hacks, they fix like all the glitches and stuff. Like they don't like allow like a lot of glitches like they did in Modern Warfare 2. I think a lot of people will play Modern Warfare 3. I know I will, as long as they have like quickscoping and it's still like Black Ops, like they gimped it. It was stupid. Like I quit Black Ops because it just got boring. Just keep using like guns over and over again. I really like to quickscope and snipe, but in Black Ops you really couldn't do that because they just were gay and just made it stupid. They gimped it. Battlefield 3 though, it looks really good because I like the graphics. The graphics look really cool. And the only reason I don't think I might not play Battlefield 3 is because I have Battlefield Bad Company 2. And the way, like just the way like that you move in that game, it's just kind of weird from Modern Warfare 2 after you played that game for a while. It's just really hard to like play. Another thing I want to talk about is, have you came back to Modern Warfare 2 from Black Ops? Like, what I mean by that is, did you quit Black Ops because you thought it was stupid? Like, do you just don't like Treyarch? Or, like, anything that you think that you've quit Black Ops for, leave it in the comments. I'd like to know what you guys think. I quit Black Ops because I just thought it was stupid. Like, I don't know. Modern Warfare 2, I actually, like, if some days when I'd get, like, ripped or wasn't doing good, like, I'd still want to stay on. But Modern Black Ops, I can't stand it. Like, when I start getting, like, killed and all that, I just hate it, so I have to get off. Like, Modern Warfare 2, I had that enjoyment and I always wanted to be on. Couldn't get off it. Had that addictingness to it. So I just wanted to know why Yin's guys didn't or like Black Ops or why you quit it. Good clutches. I want to talk about these because I like going for clutches in Search and Destroy. I think good clutches are, this is just my opinion, but I think if you camp, or not like really camp, but like stay in like one general area in the spawn or someplace with like two places that people can come from. Like in Afghan here, when I was just on top of the hill there, you just stay on like right in that middle area on top of the hill and you just run between the two entrances to the hill. I just think it really works a lot. And I also had a clutch. I wasn't recording when I did this, but I also had a clutch up on the top of that hill also. And I found that it works really good if you just stand there or stay on that top hill and just, like, go between the two spots where people can come from. So I just think if you go between two spots on any map that you'll probably do good on a clutch. Also, if you have any good clutch ideas also, let me know in the comments. And one of the other problems I have, like, I forgot to mention this in, but like when I was talking about Battlefield 3 and Modern Warfare 3, I think they need to get rid of hit markers on sniper rifles. Like, I don't know, but it's weird, but, like, some days I'll just get a game full of hit markers. Like, I don't understand. And then, like, another day I'll just get, like, a whole bunch of just one-shot kills. Like, I don't think there should be any such thing as a hit marker with a intervention or any kind of sniper rifle on any game, because if you think about it, I mean, the bullet is huge. Like, in real life, you would just, like, probably not survive a bullet from a sniper rifle. Like, maybe if they just made, like, a thing where maybe if you get hit in your foot or your arm or your hand, but everywhere else, I think you should die. Because, I mean, personally, I think if you get hit in the arm with a bullet from an intervention or any kind of sniper rifle, your hand is going to be blown off and you are going to be bleeding out, and, like, you're not probably going to survive. So, I don't know. I just think they should really get hit, rid of the hit markers. Now, with, like, assault rifles and other stuff like that, I can see hit markers being in there, but I just hate when I get hit markers and I have, like, a UMP scrub, and that's also, I just hate UMPs. If you use UMPs and you're watching this right now, sorry, but I just think you're a scrub. Like, UMP is so overpowered, it's so, like, easy to use. You have marathon and lightweight on there, and it's just overpowered, because any other gun, you have to have stopping power, usually, for it to be, like, really powerful. And I just hate that so bad. Alright, well, this is coming to the end of this commentary. If you want more from me, just rate, comment, subscribe, tell me what you want. Alright, this is Zirconium Xenon here. I'm out.
Before.